have developed a game on this called Toxic Tankz. It's basically a tank game where you run around, drive around and shoot at the other tank. Kind of a two-player game. It's implemented on the sideboard using the VGA, the plugins that we have here.
You can see the system right there.
Yeah. So we control the players on the board using the UART communication from our PC. And
we move the tanks through the keyboard on the computer.
Yep.
As you can see, we have on the screen two tanks, one blue and the other one green. We are moving it through this computer right now. We'll show you a demo later.
Can you explain shortly what your system consists of?
Yeah, so our system consists of the RGB to VGA controller, we have the sync processing system, and we have some interrupts that interrupt the screen and update the screen.
And all this stuff works
from here?
Yes,
Is it only this board that you're using, or are you also running something on the PC?
We are only using the cyberboard, but we have programmed this cyberboard on the PC.
Yeah. So aren't you sending anything from the PC to the cyberboard during the gameplay?
Yeah, we are sending user inputs from the PC to the cyberboard.
So on the serial port. So you're using the serial terminal.
Yeah, through the serial port.
Yep.
Yes.
We have connected the interrupts that update the screen to the VSync in order to make it more stable, so it doesn't flicker and have any artifacting problems.
And the screen is controlled by the FPGA, right?
Yes.
FPGA
yes. And the interrupt is triggered by edge trigger. So
it gets an edge from the VSync, it triggers the interrupt instead of having a level trigger that triggers when it gets to a certain level.
Okay. So can you show them how it works?
Yes. So we move the player one using the keyboard. We have bind it to the WASD, WAD, because we have made it so that you can move backwards. You rotate the player, and then you can only move forwards. Then you fire it by pressing S. Choose a little projector. Second player works much as the same way as the first player, move around using the numpad, and then shoot.
So both players can play simultaneously, right? It's not a turn taking.
You can see when I'm pressing here, both of the players are moving, and the players can fire. And of course, when you hit somebody, the other players die, and it announces the winner on the computer.
The game only consists of one round. So it's just if you get shot, you're dead, and then there will be a winner. In this case, we haven't implemented
the victory screen.
Exactly.
Okay.
But we will do that later on.
Okay. So in this project, what was the most difficult thing that you've achieved?
Personally, I had a lot of trouble with implementing the shots, as you saw before, because we used a linked list to, in order to ensure that we can keep firing as many shots as we need, and adding it easily. We don't have the restrictions of an array. We had a few problems with removing the shots after a certain amount, because we simply forgot to free up the allocated memory and stuff like that, and not pointing it to the right thing. And it took a little bit of sketching and figuring out.
Okay. So what's the thing that you're most proud of from this project?
That we have two tanks that can move, shoot, kill,
and everything simultaneously.
Yeah, and works. So two players can play at the same time, which is like one of the most important things of this.
That's also one of the few problems we had to begin with. The program moves so slowly that the players couldn't take the same turn. We suspect that might have something to do with the fact that we're using the UART control that can only send one signal through at a time. But in the end, we managed to make the program fast enough that it doesn't have any problems with that.
Okay, so thank you.